You had me at your six-figure salary. Yeah, I guess that's not very romantic, but is it accurate? I read an article a while back, actually a few months ago, and I'm only now responding to it, but it got me thinking. I didn't have a chance to YouTube about it until now, so I thought I would do so at this point, and here I go. By the way, the name of this video is Are Women Natural Born Gold Diggers? That's the tentative title. It may change by the time I post it. So I read this article, and it was written earlier this year and appeared in the Sunday Times. Actually, I read it on the website of the Sunday Times, which I think is an English paper. It was, the article was called Wealthy Men Give Women More Orgasms. I repeat, Wealthy Men Give Women More Orgasms. Well, duh. I don't know why everybody was so surprised by this. For some reason, this surprises people, but who would deny that good-looking women give men stiffer erections? I suppose political correctness is alive and well in America and Britain. Anyway, here's a summary of the article. Actually, these are the opening lines from the piece, so I offer a link to this article, probably to the left of the screen, or whatever. Is it the left? Whatever. Anyway, I'm offering a link to this article so you can read it yourself. And here's some of the opening lines. Scientists have found that the pleasure women get from making love is directly linked to the size of their partner's bank balance. The article continues, they found that the wealthier a man is, the more frequently his partner has orgasms. Women's orgasm frequency increases with the income of their partner, said Thomas Paulette, the Newcastle University psychologist behind the research. He believes the phenomenon is an evolutionary adaptation that is hardwired into women, driving them to select men on the basis of their perceived quality. The study is certain to prove controversial, the author says, suggesting that women are inherently programmed to be gold diggers. Now, that's probably the key line there. That's the key line I want to emphasize. The study suggests to many that women are inherently programmed to be gold diggers. And I hope to answer this question in a moment. Anyway, but what the author then concludes, and this is important as well, however, the study fits into a wider body of research known as evolutionary psychology, which I love, by the way, which suggests that both men and women are genetically predisposed to ruthlessly exploit each other to achieve the best chances of survival for their genes. I recommend the selfish gene theory by Richard Dawkins, by the way. Again, all this can be found on Times Online. Okay, so I provide the link here. So to me, there's nothing controversial or surprising about these findings. It doesn't shock me in any way, shape, or form. Studies show that women almost universally place more value in their partner's income bracket than men do. Okay, I think most of us know this anecdotally, but the evidence has backed this up. This is where the anecdotal evidence matches the empirical evidence, where the acquisitional knowledge matches up with the experiential knowledge. So again, studies show that women value the status of their partners more than men value the status of women. Now, for instance, a study by David Buss, I think a psychologist, concluded that women rate good financial prospect in a partner higher than men do. Again, not surprising. David C. Geary, in his excellent treatment of sex differences, male-female, again, I link that, you can check that out, he addresses this research in great detail, and he writes, in summary, in David Buss's research on marriage preferences, he looked at 37 samples of men and women, totaling more than 10,000 people, across 33 countries, 6 continents, and 5 islands. And this is where these were the people that had the survey administered to them. They were asked on their mate choice preferences. Women rated good financial prospect higher than men in all 37 cultures. So look at this. 37 cultures across 33 countries, 6 continents, and 5 islands. And they found that this was universal, that women put more value. This is not cultural. It's not culture that says women look for high status men. Culture may reinforce biology, but it's biology that predisposes women to valuing these things. That doesn't make it good or bad. Humans are innately aggressive too. That doesn't make violence good. But you have to be honest about this thing. And innate means inborn, not inevitable. It doesn't mean it has to be this way. It just means it tends to be this way. These things can be, I won't go into great detail, but these things are not inevitable. But here's the point. 37 cultures, and they find that in every case, women value the status of their partners more than men do. Another study, Hatfield and Sprecher, I don't know why I'm so bad with last names, found that the same pattern for groups of college students in the United States, Japan, and Russia. Pretty different cultures there, societies. In all three cultures, women rated SES, which I presume is socioeconomic status, as being more important in a prospective mate than the average man did. Again, this comes from David C. Gary's Male Female, page 127. Okay, so no surprises there. So, like I said, this is where anecdotal evidence and empirical evidence match up, where acquisitional and experiential knowledge come together. Look, we're really talking about things that most of us already know, that women like high-status men. I think that one of the reasons we deny this is simply political correctness. It seems to suggest something negative about women, that women are programmed to be gold diggers. And I think that's a politically incorrect thing to say, because we in our culture, we tend to criticize people who just go after money, who are greedy, and we see these as bad things, but we kind of give women a pass for searching for men who make lots of money, for the fact that women like men who make gobs and gobs of cash. There is a double standard there. We largely let women off the hook, not completely. Political correctness is sort of the way of reconciling this hypocrisy. Okay, so political correctness is a culprit here. Women value status in much the same way men value physical appearance, although women value physical appearance too, of course. A gold digger to me is someone who chooses a mate solely or mostly due to his or maybe her money. But even well-to-do professional women pursue high-status males. They certainly prefer them. For example, in Matt Ridley's The Red Queen, he writes, this comes from page 268 of his book. Research shows that American women who make more money than the average American woman pay more attention than average to the wealth of potential spouses, not less. Higher earning women value the earning capacity of their husbands more, not less, than low earning women, Ridley says. Even a survey of 15 powerful leaders of the feminist movement revealed that they wanted still more powerful men. Okay, so wealthy men, wealthy women, professional women still want men who make lots and lots of money. It's hard to argue that makes them gold diggers. That makes them, it means they seek partners with, you know, that are high status, but, you know, is that gold digging in the traditional sense? Not necessarily. They're weighing multiple factors. They want a man who's attractive, who's good in bed, they can relate to on a personal level, who's a good listener, but they also want a guy who makes lots and lots of money. It just happens to be that the more money a woman makes, interestingly enough, the more economically independent she is, the more she wants her partner to make lots and lots of cash. So that's not really gold digging, it's just a kind of status seeking, but it's seeking high status in your partners, not just for yourself.